Multi-state symbols are a great way to emphasize parts of our displays to catch a user's eye when certain process values need our attention. In this video, we'll be converting some of our static and dynamic symbols into multi-state symbols in order to make those important process values really grab the user's attention when it's most important. So, here in my boiler overview display, we've been having problems with our drum level overflowing. And what we did was we converted it to a multi-state symbol, and we're triggering the multi-state symbol at 80. So going back in time to a place where drum level exceeded 80, we can see that it turns bright red, and it quickly becomes the most important thing on the display. So even if you know nothing about the boiler overview process, seeing it switch from blue to red when it reaches above 80, you can tell that this is really important. So back in my mixing tank 1 display that we made in the last video, my mixer being inactive is actually a really important part of my process. And being the same color, size, and shape as all my other values doesn't really do it the justice it needs. Let's go into build mode, select the value, and edit its multi-state. Here, the first thing to do is select the data source that your multi-state is going to trigger off of. If you know the PI point, you can type it in there or search for it there. But since Mixing Tank 1 is in my AF structure, I'm going to use this pull-down menu to search my AF tree. I know it's in production line 1, and there it is. And we'll set the attribute to mixer. And the next thing to do is choose the states. So I want 2 states, one for active, one for inactive. All multi-state symbols also have another state for when there's bad data, but we'll leave that one blank. The next one we'll choose state 1. So state 1 will take a value of 0. And because my PI point is using a digital state, 0 is mapped to the string active, and 1 is mapped to the string inactive. So we'll change this to a blue color, because remember, 0 is mapped to active, and we want that to be the normal blue. But state 2 is mapped to a 1, and the digital value that represents is inactive. So we'll change the color to red. If we ever want to remove the multi-state configuration, we can click this button. So we'll hit OK instead, and we can see here, because it's currently inactive, it changes to red. And moving forward to where it's active, we can see it turn back into blue. The next thing we'll do is go back into build mode and select our mixer. And we can convert this static symbol into a dynamic multi-state symbol by editing its multi-state. And we'll repeat a similar process using Mixing Tank 1's attribute called mixer. And it'll still have 2 states. Remember, the first one's active. And we'll remove the color change from this state. And in state 2, we'll also remove the color change, but we'll make it blink. So I'll hit OK. And then going back into run mode, sliding back into a time when the mixer's inactive. We can see that the value turns bright red and the mixer starts to blink. So we can see that the mixer's inactive and there might be a problem with this part of my process here. Something else that's really important to my process is this level here. This level, like the one in my boiler overview display, is at risk of overflowing when it gets too high. So we'll convert it into a multi-state symbol, but this time I'm going to use 3 states. The first state will be a normal operation state, and that'll go from 0 to 8, and I'll keep it this blue color. The next one I want to be a caution state, and we'll color that yellow from 8 to 9. And the final state we'll use is a warning state, and we'll put that in red and make it blink. So editing the multi-state, This time we'll use the attribute level. And we're going to bump the states up to 3 states. So now we have to choose the boundaries of our states. And we can see here that the lower level is bound at 1 because it's gray and I can't change it. That's because the PI point is configured to only have values between 1 and 10. So the first state, like I said, will be between 1 and 8 and will remain blue. The next state, we can see here that the lower bound is set to the previous state's upper bound, and we can change the upper bound. So state 2 will be between 8 and 9 and be yellow. And finally, state 3, which is, again, the lower bound of state 3 is the state 2's upper bound. And the upper bound of state 3 is set to the tag's expected maximum value. So I don't need to change these values, but I will change the color change to red and make it blank. So hitting OK, we've now converted it to a multi-state, and we'll run mode and go back in time to a place where it exceeds 8. So we can see here that it turns yellow once it's above 8. And going back in time a little bit more, once it's above 9, it turns bright red and flashes. In this video, we learned how to convert dynamic and static symbols into multi-state symbols, and we can see that they're a great way to let your process engineers know exactly when something needs their attention.